Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Numbers are up. Cases are up 44% in some respects. Is this the beginning of post-spring break, the middle, the end? Is this a third wave, a fourth wave?
Well, it depends how you count, Larry. Yeah. Definitely at least the third wave, and it is going up. And there's a variety of reasons. It's not any one thing. Part of it is the variants that are out there. The B.1.1.7 variant that was first reported in Britain has gone from 1% at the beginning of February to 27% now. This is about 60% more transmissible and 60% more lethal. So that's part of the problem. Spring break is part of the problem. It's a variety of things.
Well, with people getting so many people being vaccinated, I think people are kind of lulled into this. Well, this can't be that bad because so many more people are vaccinated. Is that a false sense of security?
Well, I don't know, Robin. The vaccines are really helping. And yeah. The one thing that could happen with this wave is that it gets really blunted compared to the last few waves. Mm. And that's why we have this race going on now to vaccinate as many people as possible, as quickly as possible. And it's just this race down to the finish line. Because if that happens, you know, a lot of more people are going to be protected from these waves.
There seems to be some confusion about whether if you're vaccinated, can you still spread COVID? The CDC seemed to walk something back over the past few days.
Yes, the recommendations have changed since last Friday when we talked. And the reason for this is because we're having this wave. And why are we having the wave? We're having the wave for a couple reasons. One is that the vaccines are not 100%. You know, even the best ones are 90, 95% effective. So you've got some people are not protected. And so they are contagious. And then you have these variants out there. And the variants, the vaccines don't work as good with the variants. They work, but not as good. And so everyone is just a little nervous now to loosen up the mitigation recommendations because of those factors.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions. You have explained that once a group of people in a group of family friends are vaccinated, they can get together without masks, social distancing. Do you have any suggestions about what to do when this group has children, if all the adults are vaccinated but the kids are not?
Well, the kids can't get vaccinated. And the kids are not the big source of the virus that we had originally heard of, you know. So the problem now is this recommendation is getting walked back this week. I haven't seen the actual writing, but that's what the word on the street is. And they're gonna say, yes, if you're vaccinated, you are at lower risk, but you still need to be careful now in these groups.
All right, I'm sorry, doctor. Here's the next question. How are the COVID vaccine trials being tested? Are fully vaccinated people living their lives without masks and social distancing? Are the participants knowingly being exposed to the virus?
Yeah, so the COVID vaccine trials are enormous. They're 30,000 to 44,000 people in each one of these trials, and sometimes there's even more than one trial per vaccine. So there's tens of thousands of people that have been in these studies. They get one group gets the vaccine, one group gets placebo, and then they see how many people get COVID. So it's symptomatic COVID is what the primary endpoint is. That's what the vaccine measures. And this is what you see, oh, it's 90% effective or 95% effective, or for this vaccine, it's 67% effective. Then they look at how many people end up in the hospital. And they all seem to keep people out of the hospital. And then how many people die. And there's a significant decrease in mortality, almost 100% in all the studies. So those are the things that they measure in these clinical trials.
All right, last question. Do you recommend pregnant women receive the vaccine as soon as they can, or should they wait until the beginning of the third trimester?
Well, there's really no recommendation. There's no formal recommendation out there. Matter of fact, one of the recommendations is that if a woman becomes pregnant after the first dose, so if early in the pregnancy, she should continue with the vaccine schedule in 3 to 4 weeks to get the second dose. So, I mean, that's a recommendation. There has been no safety signals shown with the vaccine. We talked about last week that study from Northwestern with all the antibodies in the cord blood, and the babies are protected and the mothers are protected. We know that pregnant women have a hard time when they're pregnant if they get COVID. So it's all a balance. So, you know, people just, you know, the obstetricians are very keen about this. They're very tuned in, and you have to have a frank discussion with them and see, you know, if you should be taking the vaccine. But it's at this point, there's no formal recommendation. It's a personal decision.
All right, Dr. Murphy, if you have a question for him, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow at this time. Thanks so much.
Thanks, doctor.